Morning, everybody, and welcome to this workshop. The coordinators would have received a mail from Dr. Mukta Atre saying that we have a brief formal inaugural function. We have requested Professor Sukhatme, our ex-director, to kindly come and inaugurate the workshop. Our director, Professor Devang Kakkar, will also be joining. And so will be several other important heads of academic units such as Mechanical Engineering Department, Computer Science Engineering, and also the head of Center for Distance Education Program and the head of Continuing Education Program. We'll of course have some faculty members here. You'll of course be seeing all of them. We'll start this formal program at 9:30. We are at about 9:07, so I will be starting this interaction with different centers. These are not necessarily in any order, but we have selected 5 institutions which represent 5 different states of the country, and these 5 I will be coming to in the stated order starting sharp at 9:30 onwards. Please remember that 9:30 to 9:40 is when we would like this interaction to be seen by the participants of this inaugural function who would be assembled here at 9:30, because as you know, we are doing this long distance, and therefore speakers here will not ordinarily be able to see you, although you are all attending from 31 different remote centers. So let me just take the names of these 5 colleges. Please don't feel bad about this choice. This has been drawn almost like a lottery from amongst the available colleges belonging to different states. And we have chosen 5 because that is exactly what we will have about 10 minutes time from 9:30. The modus operandi will be the same that I will be following while interacting with other centers. I will name a center. We'll briefly go over to that center. We'll just say hello to the coordinator. We would like to see the glimpse of participants who have assembled there. And then we'll come back and go to another center. So this is what we'll do now, starting another 2 minutes. But before that, let me read out the list of names of colleges whom we will be contacting from 9:30 onwards. The first one is SVNIT Surat, which is in the state of Gujarat. The second one is Cummins College in Pune, which is in state of Maharashtra. The third one is JNTU at Hyderabad. So JNTU at Hyderabad, representing Andhra Pradesh. The fourth one is Anna University in Chennai, representing Tamil Nadu. And the fifth one is Amal Jyoti College, representing Kerala. As I said, these are random choices. We have, of course, 31 remote centers. So between now and 9:30, I would like to quickly go over to each remote center very, very briefly, just to ascertain that the connection is working fine, that you are able to see me and listen to my voice, and similarly, we are able to see you and listen to your voice. The first center is NIT Tiruchirappalli.
Coordinator NIT Tiruchi.
Good morning.
Can you hear my voice?
Yes, yes. We can hear you loud and clear. I hope our audio
over to you,
is
sir.
Also equal. Thank
Good
you.
Morning,
thank you. Right. So let's go to VNIT Nagpur. Good morning,
sir.
VNIT Nagpur. We can see you very clearly.
Yes.
Are you? Wonderful. Professor Gokhale, nice talking to you.
Yes, sir. You know, good morning. I came just last week, you know, and then this is the first official assignment, and I'm very glad, you know, that we are undertaking this particular exercise during the summer month. You know, it's pretty hot over here. I know it is raining in
Mumbai.
You know, if you would be able to send us some rains, you know, it would be very helpful. You know.
Well, I do not know whether thermodynamics will directly help, but we can request Professor Gaitonde to try that. Thank you so much, Professor Gokhale, for personally participating. We'll go to GH Rai Soni College, Nagpur. Yeah, good morning. I can hear you and I can also see you.
Good morning, sir.
Thank
sir,
you so much. The connection seems to be good. Are you able to receive our video well?
Okay, sir.
Thank you, sir.
By the way, I hope that all users are aware that in case of a problem, they can send a chat message and we would be able to quickly correct situation if there is any problem. Let's go over to COEP, College of Engineering, Pune. Yes, Dr. Kulkarni, I can hear you loud and clear. I can see several participants there.
Our director, Dr. Sarsavade, wants to interact with you for a minute.
Good morning to all of you. And it's a welcome feature that all the, faculty are going to be empowered in teaching of thermodynamics, That's a very difficult subject for students.
Well, thank you, Professor Sarsavade, for personally joining us. And we are happy that COEP is continuing the relationship with IIT Bombay. Thank you so much. Let us try going over to MEFCO Schlenk Institute at Shivakashi. I would like you to confirm, sir, whether you can hear me and you can see me clearly. Yes, over sir. To you.
Your voice and video are good, sir.
Thank you so much. I recall that last December when I had come to Shivakashi to give a keynote address, this is precisely the hall where I had a cup of tea with your director and other dignitaries. Sweet memories of your place. Thank you, sir, for participating.
Very good morning, Professor. This is Dr. Balakrishnan, Principal from MEFCO. So nice to talk to you. The audio and the video quality are good.
Thank you, Professor, and thank you very much for personally participating. This encourages all the participants, to put in their best. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
As I would like to mention it to rest of colleague participants from other places, that Amruta University has been a strong partner in this endeavor. And in fact, the application that we are using for the audio-video interaction, the AVU application, has been developed by a large and dedicated team working at Amruta under the leadership of Dr. Kamal Bijlani. So I am glad to go over to Amruta. Please confirm whether you can see us and hear us. Over to you, Amruta.
Yeah, good morning, sir. We can hear as well as see you very well. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much. Let me try Walchan College, Sangli. I can see Walchan College participants. Please confirm whether you can see us and hear us.
We can see you and hear you very well. I would like to just say good morning to all the participants as well as the resource persons of this course. And this is a nice initiative taken by IIT to start a course on thermodynamics. Thank you very much.
Over to you, sir.
Thank you. And thank you, Professor, for participating personally. Thank you so much. With this, we will halt this interaction temporarily and start the formal function in a moment. Let me request Professor Sukhatme and Professor Khakkar, our director, to kindly come and take the seats here. I would also request Professor Gayatonde and Professor Bhandarkar, the teachers of this course, to join them. We will continue our interaction very briefly with the five colleges which I mentioned earlier. We'll go to the Cummins College at Pune. I can see participants from Cummins College and the dignitaries are watching you. Please confirm whether you can hear us and see us. Over to you, Cummins College.
Yes, sir, I can hear you. Good morning, sir, and good morning all the dignitaries on the dais. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much. The next college we go to is JNTU Hyderabad. I can see participants from JNTU Hyderabad. Likewise, we would like you to confirm whether you can see us and hear us. Over to you.
Good morning, sir. This is Bramara, along with the coordinator, Professor Vijay Kumari, and about 50 participants. All of us wish you good morning, sir. Over to you.
Thank you so much. You have 60 participants. That's a large number. Thank you so much. We'll now be going over to Anna University, Chennai.
Yeah, we are able to hear you properly. The video is also very clear. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you so much. And last but not the least, we go over to Amal Jyoti College, Kerala.
Yeah, this is Father Jules, the principal of Amal Jyoti College of Engineering, Kanyarapalli, Kerala. And all of us are here. We have got 43 participants, and the audio as well as the video clarity is excellent. We can get you very well. We can also hear you, listen you properly, and things are fine. I hope that you also can see us and listen to what we speak. And all of our best wishes, and we are extremely happy that we can interact with IIT Bombay. And thank you very much for having taken us as the participant. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Father. Thank you for personally gracing the occasion. And yes, I confirm that we can see you absolutely clearly and we can hear you absolutely clearly. In fact, this is the very purpose of using this technology, that we can actually participate as if you are attending the course from IIT Bombay itself, except you don't have to physically move long distance. And over the next 2 weeks, you and your participants will find that the interaction with the resource persons at IIT Bombay is as good as if you were personally attending it in IIT. Thank you so much. So let me start this function by formally welcoming the dignitaries, the chief guest, Professor Sukhatme. Thank you so much for coming here, sir. Our director, Professor Devang Khakkar. Thank you, Devang. Thanks for coming. Professor Gayatonde, who has agreed to conduct this program for us, jointly with his colleague, Professor Bhandarkar. Thank you so much for coming. Please be seated. We have other senior colleagues here. We have Professor Sanyal, head of the Computer Science Department, under whose aegis we run this program. We have Professor Tembe, head of our Center for Distance Engineering Education Program. Thank you so much. And we have Professor Kannan Maudgalya, who is the Institute Coordinator for all the national mission projects at IIT Bombay. Thank you so much for coming. You see, these four people that you see here are the people who coordinate almost all of our outreach program in one way or the other. Barring, of course, my head, who coordinates all of us to deliver a proper program. Thank you so much for coming. Before handing over the proceedings to the chief guest and to Dr. Professor Khakkar, I would just like to mention that these workshops under the National Mission Project have been a dream of IIT Bombay for several years. We started doing these distance education programs almost a decade ago, but we perfected the technique over the years. We did a sort of pilot project sponsored by TIFAC, and subsequently we are doing this national mission project. This project envisages that a large number of teachers across the country should have the occasion to interact with faculty members from IIT Bombay on specific subjects, and that is how we have started this. This particular workshop is being attended by 850 teachers all across the country. My dream is we should have 1,000 plus teachers, and we have another workshop on basic electronics which Professor Dinesh Sharma is going to conduct and his colleagues starting 2 weeks later. We have again another set of 850 teachers participating. 1,206. So Dinesh Sharma, by conducting a program 2 weeks later, is able to get more teachers for us. Anyway, so we are very happy, and we are particularly happy that both Professor Khakkar and Professor Sukhatme have agreed to come here and to encourage all of us, both the participants and the teaching faculty. So without further ado, I would request my director, Professor Devang Khakkar, to say a few words.
Professor Sukhatme,
Professor Patak, distinguished colleagues in the audience, and colleagues who are with us virtually, a very warm welcome to IIT Bombay and to this workshop on thermodynamics, which is traditionally a very difficult course. First of all, I want to start by expressing my appreciation for this great technology. You know, this allows so many of us
to come together virtually and at a low cost. And I mean low cost not in just in terms of the money required for travel, but also cost in terms of time, in terms of arranging for places to stay and so forth. This is really a wonderful technology. If Professor Fatak had to organize a workshop of 850 teachers at IIT Bombay, I know that that would take at least a year of preparation and a lot of effort on all sides, including the participants. Come all the way here, spend 2 weeks away from home and so forth. So this is really a wonderful technology, and you know, I think we must explore new ways to see how this type of connectivity, how this type of computer power can be used in a big way in education. We have a huge educational ecosystem. I was told that just in Maharashtra there are 112,000 students who have joined the engineering program. So that's 1,12,000 students have joined the engineering program in Maharashtra alone, and there may be 10 million or something in the whole country. So this is a very, very huge system, and any initiative that we take will be meaningless unless it can be scaled up in a big way. And I think ICT is one means by which we can scale up to address issues which affect a very large population of students. I'm very happy that IIT Bombay has Professor G.V. Fatak, who has been a pioneer in developing techniques which allow the use of ICT in education. I feel more and more of us should be involved in this effort, and I think that this workshop program has been a great success, and I'm sure that there will be other such programs that we can think of, because such types of programs can have a major impact on the kind of education that we deliver to students across the country. I would also like to thank all my colleagues from IIT Bombay for this particular course, Professor Gaitonde and Professor Dasar, for actually participating in this intensive workshop. I know it takes a lot of their effort, and everyone in IIT is, you know, occupied 100% of the time. So I'm very happy that they have taken time off to really participate in this very important activity. Also, this is the first time I think that we are, I may be wrong in this, but the first time that a non-computer science course that we are dealing with, and I think that is also a welcome move. And we are taking a course that is, as I said right in the start, sort of considered a difficult course in engineering. Finally, let me say a couple of words about teaching, because all of us over here, or many of us, are teachers. In my opinion, I mean, for academics, teaching is the most important activity. And really, I feel that in terms of the impact that we have on the overall system, teaching undergraduates is the most important activity because of several things. One is there are more of them. Only a very small fraction of undergraduates go on for postgraduate studies. So we have a huge number of undergraduates. And so if you just look at what impact they have on the economy and on the society when they go out, I think in terms of impact, certainly an undergraduate with a good education is a great asset to the society. The second thing is that the foundations of a person's knowledge are built at that level. And really, I think there should be great clarity and when we teach undergraduates. And in a sense, we should have the best teachers teaching the youngest students. Because if we can build very good foundations, then the rest of it is easy. I think workshops such as the one being conducted are really
something by which we can address how we teach these students, how we can do a good job of teaching. And in many ways I feel that to be a competent teacher is quite straightforward. One is that one must have a thorough knowledge of the subject. The second is, of course, to be able to organize the course. The third is to, you know, systematically deliver the material. And finally, to be able to communicate with the students. And I think this is something that one can learn. Participating in such workshops is very useful. And even within IIT, we've been having a lot of discussion along these lines. We've actually had a retreat for 2 days in which our faculty are discussing among themselves how we can do this more efficiently. Our Senate has taken this up, and we have had several reports and several resolutions on how these issues can be addressed. Of course, the next level is to be a great teacher, and that is something that I think once you reach this platform, you can aspire to. And there I believe that that is something beyond all this. There is some magic in it, because finally a great teacher will inspire the student to learn on his own, because finally learning requires effort on the part of the student. And if the teacher can essentially excite the student about what they are saying and inspire the student to put in efforts to learn, I think that is really at another level, and that is something to aspire towards. So thank you very much, Professor Phatak, for inviting me, and I wish the participants all the best in this workshop. I hope you enjoy yourselves. Thank you.
Thank you, Professor Kakkar, for those very wise words. I would like all the participants to note that what our director said, that teaching, and particularly teaching at the undergraduate level, needs to be taken very seriously. You would have understood how seriously IIT Bombay itself takes this undergraduate teaching. We do indeed have very senior people teaching undergraduate students, particularly younger students. Anyway, we'll continue this interaction further over the next 2 weeks. But now I will request the chief guest of the function to come and share his thoughts with you. Let me briefly add a few points about Professor Sukhatme. He was a faculty member, a colleague for what, over 40 years. After he retired from IIT Bombay, he was given the responsibility of chairing the Atomic Energy Regulatory Board. He has been an avid researcher and a great teacher and a great institution builder. And of course, being a mechanical engineer, thermodynamics is very close to his heart. So that is why when Professor Gayathonde and I were discussing this course, ordinarily we don't have a formal inaugural function, but this time we said we would like to invite Professor Sukhatme. And when I talked to him, it so happened that he was free, and in fact, he was keen to come and talk to you. So thank you very much, Professor Sukhatme, for joining us, and I think people would like to hear you.
Good morning, everybody. Professor Kakkar, Professor Phatak, Professor Gayathonde, Professor Bhandarkar, heads of departments, colleagues, friends. It's a great pleasure to be here this morning for the inauguration of this workshop on the teaching of thermodynamics. And as Deepak said, Professor Phatak said, the moment he asked me, I said yes, for the simple reason that I have taught thermodynamics for many years. And so obviously, any workshop on this subject is of interest to me. Now, Professor Kakkar alluded to the need for such programs. We are reaching out today from here. I have an audience of only say 20 or 30 people, but I am reaching out to 700-800 people who are going to take part in this course. And that is the technology which is enabling it, the distance education, this distance education is being enabled. Earlier, the old style, we used to hold summer schools in Bombay. IIT Bombay under the QIP program or various other programs sponsored by the ministry. We'd have about 30 people come here. We'd have a work, you know, a month they would stay with us and we would lecture to them on some subject or the other, and they would go back and carry some way in which they could improve on their teaching. That's the best we could do. Today with these technologies, suddenly one can reach out to 800 people, and that's a very big thing. Now, just to give you a magnitude of Professor Kakkad mentioned the magnitudes. Today in India, the admission capacity for engineering in the country is more than 6 lakhs. All the seats are not getting filled and all have not been wisely created, but that's another issue. The point is at least 4 or 5 lakhs are getting filled every year, and mechanical engineering is probably around 25% of that. So we are talking of about 1 lakh students joining mechanical engineering every year across the country. An average class is about 60 students, sometimes more, but 60 is the norm which we use in so many ways in creating capacity. So if you divide 1 lakh by 60, you get an idea of the magnitude of the number of students who are going to be learning thermodynamics every year at some stage of that 4 years that they spend in their college or their institute. You need, let us say, approximately at least 1,000 teachers, if not more, for teaching the subject of thermodynamics every year. So today, when we reach out to about 800, we are contributing in a substantial way towards helping these teachers to improve their skills in teaching thermodynamics. Whereas if I follow the old technology and I can at most reach to 30 or 50 students right here who have to come all the way here, it's going to take me 20 years to do that. So you can see immediately the kind of impact that we are making. What is even more important is that this particular session, the 2-week program, is not just about delivering lectures from here, but also has with it a content of tutorials and problem sessions. And in order that those be conducted well at your centers, coordinators of those centers have already come here in March and spent 2 weeks with us. And that is what makes this a still stronger program in trying to convey thermodynamics. Thermodynamics cannot just be lectures. It has to be finally solving problems. In fact, that's true of all engineering courses. You can lecture and lecture, but finally students have to solve problems that are of interest from the engineering viewpoint. So we believe that with such programs, one will make a bigger impact, and it's absolutely necessary because we've created the capacity, we have the students, they pay a lot of money, they deserve the best education. At the moment, what we do is when we select teachers, we say, well, he's got a first class, he looks like a good boy or a good girl, he's interested in teaching, take him or her. And beyond that, we do nothing, literally nothing. We expect them to learn the art of teaching on their own from colleagues, or by the experience of walking into a classroom and finding out that something went right or wrong. That's really what's happening. You learn fast, of course. When you face 60 bright students all over the country, you better learn fast, otherwise you run away from the business and you say teaching is no good for me, you know, things like that. So it is very important that we have more of such programs. Now let me revert a little to thermodynamics. As I said, it's a subject to my heart because I taught undergraduate thermodynamics for many years to mechanical engineering students. And if anybody likes, if I were to use one word to describe the subject, I would say it's a beautiful subject. That's the adjective that I would use for describing a subject like thermodynamics. It's a beautiful subject for many reasons. One reason is it forms the core of what we call as an engineering science course in moving up from basic science to practical engineering subjects. For a mechanical engineer, if he has a good grounding in thermodynamics, a good grounding in fluid mechanics, a good grounding in solid mechanics and dynamics, and a good grounding in, let us say, heat transfer to some extent, you can expect that he can analyze problems, whether they be in design, whether they be in production, or whether they be in controls, whatever be the areas of application in which you move on. If he doesn't have that good grounding, he's always going to be empirical in his outlook. So a good grounding in basic engineering science is the basis for being able to analyze problems in your profession. I'm speaking of mechanical engineering. One could similarly list a set of subjects in, say, electronics, or in electrical engineering, or in computer science, and so on. There is no difficulty, but that's the point. A basic subject, a basic engineering science subject, forms the core and helps us to analyze and synthesize problems of interest. Then, of course, if you are creative, you can do something in that subject, like build new technologies and so on. But the ability to analyze comes from having a good grounding in the basic core engineering science subjects of your discipline. And that is why thermodynamics is a beautiful subject. But there is another reason why it is beautiful, because it is so close. You are trying to describe nature in a set of laws, and those laws look terribly simple, but have evolved over years and have stood the test of time to this day. First, the first and second law of thermodynamics and the zeroth law which precedes it are laws which describe nature and have now stood the test of time. And they are very beautiful laws, very simple. It is our standard question when somebody comes for admission, you say, tell me the first law. And somebody says, people say it is conservation of energy, somebody says work and heat, you know, things like that, various descriptions. But basically, in simple terms, what the first law is saying, it does not matter whether it is a work interaction, it does not matter whether it is a heat interaction. If I have a system, whether closed or open, and energy is flowing in and energy is flowing out in the form of work and heat, the algebraic sum of all that will be 0 if it is in the steady state. That is all that you are saying. It does not matter what it is. And the second law goes a step further, and that is what makes it even more beautiful. It says, look, that is fine as for what the first law says, I have no objection, but there is something more which nature does. Nature says, I can convert all of work into heat. That is what Joule did when he stirred water and heated it up, but I cannot convert all of heat to work. That is what the second law says. It is a very beautiful and a powerful statement. And then, in order to explain it, we have introduced the concept of entropy, saying entropy is a measure of disorder, work is more ordered, heat is less ordered, and that whenever a process takes place in which we go convert heat to work and get work, we are introducing order locally, but on the whole, in the world as a whole, we are increasing the measure of disorder. That is the concept of entropy, and it remains still a very important concept which has stood the test of time. But really, one does not know whether it is the only thing, that the only way to describe what is really happening. Why should necessarily there be such a concept which says entropy goes on increasing is not clear, but it stands the test of time. So, we say, well, fine, let us stick to our concept of entropy, accept that disorder is going on increasing. Somebody says, to what extent can it increase? I say, I do not know. That is what makes thermodynamics a beautiful subject. There are things still which need exploring, things of a philosophical nature which also need exploring. But on the practical side, as an engineer, thermodynamics is much more. All our problems of energy, power plants everywhere are all problems in which we are analyzing energy and trying to get the best out of those power plants, so that we can get as much work out of heat as possible. We stop worrying at that point that we are increasing the overall disorder in the world and things like that. We say, well, if it is happening, let it happen. Right now, I want work from that heat. How efficiently can I do it? And that is the last part of what we teach in engineering thermodynamics, that is trying to see what are our power conversion cycles and what are our refrigeration cycles. So, as I said, it is a very practical subject, it is a philosophical subject, and it is a subject in which you really understand that how well people have ended up describing what nature has given us. And that is what makes it, as I said, a very interesting subject. Now, let me come to the last part of what I want to talk about briefly. And that is, one can talk about a subject to a teacher and say, look, thermodynamics is this and this and this. But if you want to be a teacher, if you want to face a class of 60 every day, finally, you have to enjoy what you are doing. The business of teaching is a difficult one. People say, I can teach. Fine, everyone can teach, but the business of doing good teaching is an art which you have to develop and cultivate over the years. It never finishes. Even on the day of your retirement, you can't walk into a class and say, I know everything about teaching. There is no such thing. You are all the time learning. So, So teaching is something you have to enjoy. That's the first thing I would say to all those who are listening to me across the country. If you enjoy your job, that's the first step towards doing it well. The second thing which I want to talk about teaching, and which is maybe old fashioned because I'm getting old, is many people of course use modern technologies. I'm surrounded with gadgets just now, as you can see, monitors and things like that. But ultimately, in teaching a subject like engineering thermodynamics, there is really no substitute for having finally a teacher with 60 students in front and having a blackboard and maybe chalks of two or three colors. There is really no substitute for it. You may have PowerPoint in which you may use for showing, let's say there is a difficult sketch to draw or a difficult figure. You don't want to take up the time to draw it on the board, or it's difficult to draw. You may use some projection technique where you have to show a video of some process taking place or something like that. But when it, say, let us say, comes to explaining or deriving a law, there is very little that can substitute deriving it on the board with a chalk. There is very little substitute for it. And in that process, students learn in a manner in which it stays imprinted on their mind. Okay. Suppose, to come back again to thermodynamics, I had to teach the first law and to derive an expression for the first law for an open system or a control volume, whatever you call it. And this will be done in this class when you go along. You can straight away on a PowerPoint say this is the expression and say this stands for this, first term stands for this, second term stands for this, third term and so on. That's your expression. Nothing wrong. You've stated the first law for an open system. On the board, you'll never do that. On the board, you'll draw a system, an open system, and you say, all right, let's say there's a fluid flowing into this phase A, B. Okay, and you say, all right, this fluid is flowing in with a velocity V. And the area of this is A, right? And then you ask somebody in the class, say, all right, what's the rate at which fluid is flowing in? And the person will say, rho A V. Say, fine, you are right. Then you ask the next person, but he has made some assumptions in saying rho AV. What are those assumptions? And maybe he will answer it, maybe he won't, doesn't matter. You say, well, he has made two assumptions. He has assumed that rho is a constant, he has assumed that V is a constant across that area A. I now say to you, it is not a constant, it both are varying across that area A. So what will be the expression? He will immediately say, if he knows a little bit of calculus, he will say, put an integral. Say rho V inside the integral dA, that is the rate at which mass is flowing into that area. And now if you have said this in the class, those students, if they have got it, will never ever forget it in their lives. If you write it on the board straight away, rate at which flow is going in is rho AV dV, and then you say if rho is a constant, take it outside the integral, they may or may not quite grasp the importance of what you have done. So I am saying a board, using a board well and explaining these features is an important part of teaching, and that can only be done on a blackboard with this class which is interacting with you a little. You can't interact too much, otherwise you can't cover too much material during your 1 hour. So you need recourse to modern techniques. I am not saying don't use PowerPoint. Some PowerPoint is needed from time to time. Some what you call projections of videos are needed from time to time. But there is very little substitute for using a good using a board. Systematically, by the way, by systematic, what do I mean? Let us say the board consists of three panels. You start at the left hand panel, go down straight, finish that, go to the next panel, but don't erase the first one, because there are students who may want to write something from it. When you go to the second, go to the third, then go back again to the first. And I learned this the hard way, I can tell you, after joining IIT Bombay. When I attended, after I joined in 65, we had a very senior professor in mechanical engineering, Professor Parurekar, and you know, he used to teach thermodynamics also, incidentally. And I said to him, I'd like to attend your class, I hope you don't mind. He was, you know, said, of course not, please come. And so I attended his class, and the first thing that struck me immediately was how systematically he used the board, because I appreciated that he would go down systematically. The second thing which I appreciated about him was how many sketches he would draw on the board by teaching thermodynamics. He said, you have to picture the situation first, you have to draw a sketch, then only put down equations. He didn't believe much in equations, being an old time person. So Later on, the roles were reversed. When I taught heat transfer, he attended my classes. And he said, fine, whatever you teach is excellent, but you know, every time you draw an integral sign, I am reminded of a snake. That's all, you know, things like that. So, we were on in different, let us say, generations. But the fact is, I picked up that wisdom of how to use a board by attending his class. And I still remember that. So, the point I am trying to say basically is, in this course, we will cover, of course, thermodynamics very carefully. The teachers are outstanding teachers who are going to be covering this course for you, Professor Gaitonde and Professor Bhandarkar. So, you will get all the fundamentals, but ultimately, if you are going to face an audience of students, develop a love for the students, develop a love for teaching. You will enjoy it, the students will enjoy it, and then teaching becomes a wonderful profession in which you are proud to be going out every day and saying, I am doing something that is worthwhile for you, for your students and for the nation. So, I thank you very much for inviting me this morning. It has been a great pleasure, and with these words, let me say I have great pleasure in inaugurating this workshop on the teaching of thermodynamics. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor Sukatme, for those very encouraging and nice words. In fact, now I understand why many of your past students still remember you for thermodynamics. I wish I was taught like that. I studied thermodynamics at Indore, and it never occurred to us at that time that it would be a beautiful subject. So, but now I understand better. I hope all of you heard him very carefully when he emphasized the importance of teaching and the systematic methodology that you must adopt. I would like to add and inform all the participants and also to Sukhatme that we indeed understood the fact that only PowerPoint is not going to be very useful. So, in all our long distance teaching programs, we have a gadget which is an equivalent of a board, which is this writing pad. And in fact, I believe Professor Gaitonde rather prefers to use that than just the PowerPoints. So do we. In fact, I was an avid user of PowerPoint, but when I was teaching my programming course, I found out that a pre-written program does not appeal to the students as much as development of that program. So, I learned it from a colleague of mine, Professor Rana from Maths Department, who was using a tablet PC to write, and I have since adopted that, and I find the teaching has become far more effective. So, I entirely agree with Professor Sukhatme that a teacher must use the conventional wisdom of interacting with students, encouraging them to think and giving them picturizable, visible sort of artifacts to think about and develop the derivations rather than show completely derived things. I would also like you to remember the most important thing which he said is that if I want to be a good teacher, I must enjoy teaching. There is no substitute for doing anything well without enjoying it, and I think that is the message that you will carry with you. So, thank you very much, Professor Sukhatme, for giving us these wise words. I would also like to thank Professor Khakkar, the director of IIT Bombay, or for that matter, director of any institution. He is an extremely busy person, but you could see that he emphasized exactly the same point, the need for good teaching across the country, and he did mention that this kind of programs can reach out to large number of people, which was endorsed also by Professor Sukhatme. Let me tell you that the efforts that we are doing would not have gotten off the ground if successive directors of the institution had not supported all our early experiments. In fact, when we started it, I remember Professor Sukhatme was the director then, and we had put some very costly VSAT equipment. Subsequently, when Professor Ashok Mishra joined as the director, he encouraged it and in fact extended our distance education program to a full-fledged center, which my colleague Professor Tembe now leads, Center for Distance Engineering Education Program. So, thank you very much, Professor Khakkar, for joining us. I will not thank Professor Gaitonde and Professor Bhandarkar now. That is a job I would like to do the valedictory, and in fact, some of you, at least the coordinators, have interacted with both my colleagues here. But let me tell you that in terms of being systematic and in terms of being passionate, both of them are no less. Particularly Professor Gayathonde, whom I know for well over 35 years. Incidentally, he happens to be one of the favorite chelas of Professor Sukhatme. So there is every reason to believe that he has imbibed much of the systematic development of courses and much of the passion for teaching from him. I think we are in good hands. Let me also take this opportunity to thank several functionaries of the institution without which this kind of programs would not have happened. The two most important people are the coordinators for our continuing education program, Professor Joshi, and coordinator for our Center for Distance Engineering Education program, Professor Tembe. Let me tell you that the conventional wisdom in continuing education program is that you conduct workshops for 30 or 40 teachers, and to endorse a conduct of 850 teachers program is not very simple or straightforward, particularly when those teachers are not physically here. But our CEP establishment went two steps forward to say this is perfectly fine. They in fact help us conduct the coordinators workshops which have to be held physically in IIT, which as Professor Sukhatme said is a precursor to every such workshop that we do. Professor Tembe of course makes all the facilities of the center available to us for all interaction. In fact, the hall from which this function is being conducted is the major seminar hall for Center for Distance Engineering Education program. A project like this cannot be conducted because all projects, sponsored projects of the government or any other agency or any consultancy project, they are all conducted in IIT Bombay under the aegis of a department. This particular program is being conducted under the Department of Computer Science and Engineering. And let me tell you, Computer Science Department is currently undergoing a lot of problems. Our new building is not yet ready. We are all working in a compressed mode. Making space available for any kind of activity is difficult. The primary demands on the space are always from our research labs. It is to the credit of my head, Professor Sanyal, and to all my colleagues in the department that in spite of the space crunch for last 2 years, they have been very, very considerate in giving large space for this mission project. You might only see a few teachers talking to you, but let me tell you that there are about 50 project engineers working on several technology developments like Clicker or the AVU related development and other things. There are several managers and support staff which are working, and is almost like a very large entity itself. All of that entity can function very comfortably in the aegis of CS department, and I would like to thank Professor Sanyal and my colleagues for that. I must also thank all the other faculty colleagues who have come here to grace this occasion. I hope more of you would come forward in coming years to conduct these workshops. I am taking the point made both by Professor Khakkar and Professor Sukhatme that these programs indeed are able to help make an impact on the general teaching ethos of the engineering subjects in the country. And I promise you, sir, that we will continue this good work. The government of India, in fact, wants to expand this to not just the core courses in engineering, but even other elective courses and other things in specific areas, which will probably appear in the next plan. I would like to thank my own team members. As I said, there are 50 people. The technical people are not here, of course. They are always in the background. The technology that they develop is what we, you and I use. But they are led by my managers. The video team is led by Mr. Sajjan Kumar Dixit. Then we have our three senior admin managers, Dr. Mukta Atre. Most of the coordinators and in fact many of the participants would know because they would have interacted with her. That is Mukta for you. Mrs. Kalpana Kannan. Kalpana is sitting at the other end, yes. So she is another manager, and of course our finance minister Jaya, she handles all the finances. It is not easy to interact with 31 remote centers, getting their advances sanctioned, settling their bills. And in all the work that she and her colleagues do, we are very ably helped by an extremely efficient office of our Dean R&D. Professor Rangan Banerjee unfortunately could not come here today. I had invited him, but I would like to express my thanks to him and his office for all the support that we get. With this, I would like to conclude this inaugural function. I will personally be talking to you. I have been kindly and graciously given a slot of half an hour by Professor Gaitonde on Saturday before lunch. So this Saturday before lunch, I will be engaging with you, where I will tell you more about the spirit of this workshop and what we want, how we want to take this further. I just wanted to make one announcement. I think Professor Gaitonde has already put his first test on the Moodle. Oh, so after the tea break, this is the typical IIT style. You start your learning by solving problems. So in the typical IIT style, you will be doing that. There is also an additional questionnaire. You see, we want to measure the effectiveness of this effort, and this effectiveness can only be measured by seeing how much impact the teachers who participate in these workshops make on the learning of the students whom they teach later. So this, we have evolved a methodology, and M.Tech student is working on that, where we will begin by collecting feedback from the students whom you have taught in the past, collecting feedback from you now, collecting feedback from you after the workshop, and collecting feedback from you and your students in the future. It's a long drawn process. We are just beginning to do that. But the first feedback that we would like to collect is from the 850 participating teachers before they start the workshop, to assess in their own mind what is the state of preparedness and what is the state of their experience in teaching this course. So please make sure that before the course becomes old, just as you will answer Professor Gaitonde's technical quiz, I would request you earnestly to answer those 9 questions. It will not take more than 6 or 7 minutes. That is on the Moodle. Over and out. Thank you very much.